Hello guys, good morning. Hope you understand the envelope of a prokaryote. Prokaryote is cell boundary that made up of a three layers, innermost cell membrane and second cell wall. Cell wall is also covered by glycocalyx. It is very complex structure, right? But in this session, I am going to provide the details regarding envelope of the eukaryotic cells. Eukaryotic means except bacteria. Protozoans, plants, animals and everything, there was a cell membrane. Of course, some plants and fungi, algae also have a cell wall. That cell wall structure here we are not going to discuss. Only thing is cell membrane. So many students have a confusion. Do the cell membrane and plasma membrane and biomembrane are same? Obviously. Different scientists, their collaborations worked out and gave cell membrane, plasma membrane and biomembrane. Who are the scientists coined all these names and what exactly the model we have to follow to understand the cell membrane structure? That first we have to discuss membranes that are very thin layers that are covering the cells which are selectively permeable are called cell membrane. Who told this is Nageli and Krenko, are the two scientists together said that cell membrane. Cell membrane is also called plasma lemma. Lemma means layer. Also called plasma membrane or biomembrane. All these three are same and named by J.Q. Plow. So these are the two scientists have an historical aspect regarding the naming of the cell membrane. But the detailed cell structure of the plasma membrane studied after invention of the microscopes that happened in 1950s. Fluid mosaic model. This is a very familiar and well accepted till today. Most familiar and well accepted cell membrane theory is fluid mosaic theory, also called fluid mosaic model. Who given is Singer and Nicholson in 1972. So generally, if you compare the cell membrane of a prokaryote and eukaryote, one should understand the difference. Prokaryotic cell membrane consists of proteins and lipids majorly. Carbohydrate percentage may be or may not be. But here, proteins, carbohydrates and lipids should be present. And one more important thing is, cell membrane of one animal to another animal or cell membrane of one plant to another plant is various in their composition. In case of a human, if you take the RBC, red blood cell membrane, protein percentage is 50 and lipid percentage is 40. So it is various in the human cell itself. One human cell membrane is a differentiation with the composition of cell membrane with another cell of human only. Various animals, they have a compositions are different. Leave it. If you study the fluid mosaic model neatly, you can understand how does this membrane is executed. Mostly animal cell membranes are bilipid layers. Two lipid layers are arranged parallelly. Let us see the clean structure of a plasma membrane proposed by the Singer and Nicholson. Now, if it is a cell, this is the cytoplasm, this is cell membrane. Just take this cell membrane in extent. This cell membrane has two layers of lipids. That's why it is called lipid bilayer. All eukaryotic cell membranes are made up of lipid bilayer. For our better understanding, I am going to expand these two structures. So, hydrophilic heads are projecting outside in the one layer. This is what? This. If you see this one, so each layer consists of lipid molecule. If you observe in the one, this is called hydrophilic head and this is hydrophobic tail. Like that, many lipid molecules are arranged serially and form one layer. These two together called lipid bilayer. Right? The head is projecting outer surface. This is outside and this is inside. This is what executing the normal structure of cell membrane in any animal. All these are polar head and non-polar tails will be there. Polar head means what? All heads are projecting outsides. That's why they are called polar heads. Heads are polar and tails are non-polar. So this is general structure, not a Singer and Nicholson structures. And Singer and Nicholson structures is a peculiar. They are telling that animal cell membranes are eukaryotic cell membranes, mainly made up of a bilipid layer or lipid bilayer, and their heads are projecting outside and their tails are projecting inside. These two layers are bonding with van der Waals bonds. There is no direct connection, there is a gap. Because of van der Waals forces, these two are bonding. So this is similar to this. Then what is the difference between normal cell membrane structure and a structure or model proposed by the Singer and Nicholson means? Singer and Nicholson said that between this lipid bilayer, some protein structures are embedded. So they are called internal proteins. So these two are called bilipid layer. Bilipid layer. In between the bilipid layer, some proteins were arranged. Apart from the proteins, surface of the outer surface, if you think this is the outer surface, towards the outer surface, some carbohydrates structures are also present. They are carbohydrates. They explained. They just executed like icebergs in between the lipid layer. Which theory? Singer and Nicholson theory is telling that proteins are icebergs in the sea of lipids. Here C is resembled by lipids. And proteins are resembling the iceberg. And it is also gulab jamuns in the sugar solution. Gulab jamun is like a protein and gulab jamun is dipped in the sugar solution. So sugar solution is like a lipids. And entire this component have two important things. One is phospholipid. Second one is protein. So phospholipids and proteins together form cell membranes. Is the conclusion. If you discuss individually what is phospholipids, what is the role of proteins inside it, some proteins are embedded partially, some embedded fully, some proteins if you see, there are only partial proteins, some are fully embedded. Fully embedded proteins means what? They cover outer surface as well as inner surface. Partial proteins means what? They cover either outer surface or only inner surface. So let us have a clear details about the phospholipids and protein content in the cell membrane model which is proposed by Singer and Nicholson. Come, let's understand about the phospholipids. Phospholipids are main components. Why? Because they are continuous layers. In between the phospholipids, proteins are arranged. First, you have to concentrate to learn about only phospholipids, later proteins, step by step. So phospholipids are main components. They form continuous layer. So this is entire continuous layer. They are phospholipids. Because of them, some fluidity will be there. So who provide the fluidity to the plasma membrane means phospholipids. That's why I have mentioned just before, according to the Singer and Nicholson theory, sugar solution that contains the gulab jamun. Here the gulab jamun is not phospholipid. Clear, gulab jamun is a protein. What is a phospholipid? The sugar solution. So sugar solution gives fluidity. Clear? Now It is rich in unsaturated fatty acids. Because of the presence of unsaturated fatty acids, it gets fluidity. If question comes like that, plasma membrane is having some fluidity due to the presence of phospholipids. The main type of phospholipids in the cell membrane structures are serine, lecithin and cephalin. So before the animal tissue, we have discussed that cephalin, lecithin is present in the alveolar membrane of the lungs, right? And cephalin is present in the neural membrane. They are also helps in some transport. It helps in which one? The phospholipids are helps in cell growth. I am not talking completely about the cell membrane. In cell membrane, there is a part which is a major part is called phospholipids. Due to the phospholipids, cell is getting repaired, cell is getting growth, cell is able to divide, and also cell able to secrete. What are the functions of phospholipids, or what is the role of phospholipids in the cell membrane? Means cell growth, cell junctions, cell secretions and cell divisions, etc. So this is about phospholipids. Phospholipids are forming continuous layer. They are fluid in nature because the presence of unsaturated fatty acids. They are major component. The main type of phospholipids available in the nature are serine, lecithin and cephalin. What are the functions of phospholipids? Means cell growth, cell repair, cell division and also cell secretion. They are also forming cell junctions. Cell junctions we already seen in the epithelial tissue, right? Gap junctions, adherence junctions, tight junctions. All these are because of only presence of phospholipids. In this, there is no role of the protein. Let us see what is the role of protein in the cell membrane structure. The last part in this session, that is proteins. According to the locations and the functions, the proteins in the cell membrane has been classified into two things. One is integral proteins. They are also called intrinsic proteins that have an association with the phospholipid layer. Peripheral proteins that do not have an association. They are surface proteins present on the top or outside of the lipid layer. They are called extrinsic proteins. Do you want to see both the proteins locations by the help of this diagram? Let us see. Firstly, integral proteins. You think this is a protein. This is integrated with the cell membrane or phospholipid layer. So that's why they are called internal proteins or integrated proteins. This is also integrated protein. And this is also integrated protein. So integrated proteins may embedded or buried completely or partially. So intrinsic proteins, again two types, partially embedded and fully embedded. Partially embedded means what? They are connecting with either one surface, outer surface or inner surface. This is towards inner surface, this is towards outer surface. But if you see this one or this one, they are connecting with both outer surface as well as inner surface. So, proteins that are embedded in the phospholipid layer, they have contact with both the surfaces of the cell, outer surface and inner surface, then that is called fully embedded proteins. These proteins' main nature is
some water-soluble molecules, minerals, glucose and some alcohol components can easily transfer from exterior to interior through these channels. Wherever some charged ions and components and large molecular weight components cannot pass through this. Selectively, this membrane passes chemical components from exterior to interior or interior to exterior.
Water-soluble elements easily can pass through them. So water-soluble elements can easily pass through them in the both the directions. Through these proteins they can go. That's why they are also called channel proteins. Why does fully embedded proteins in the cell membrane called as channel proteins? Because they are connecting both the surfaces. That's why water-soluble elements can travel from outside to inside or inside to outside according to their gradient pressure or concentration through them. Clear? So partial embedded do not help in the passage, but they helps in the holding. Clear? So these two are not easily removable. Not easily removable. On the other hand, peripheral proteins are also called external proteins are there. These proteins are present only outer surface, but they are not embedded, means they are not integrated with the cell membrane. They are present just the surface. That's why they are also called surface proteins. Surface proteins have enzymatic activations or enzymatic actions. Clear? They are easily removable. They can remove easily. So these are the differences between integrated proteins and peripheral proteins, or intrinsic proteins or extrinsic proteins. So total cell membrane of the eukaryotic composition is various with one cell to another cell. According to the Singer and Nicholson, cell membrane is a fluid mosaic model. Fluid mosaic means inside the fluid some proteins are embedded, just like an example of an iceberg with the sea and gulab jamus in the sugar solution. So what are the major components of the cell membrane? Two. One is phospholipid, another one is protein. So phospholipids are providing cell growth and cell repair, cell junctions as well as secretions. Proteins are helping in the transport as well as some enzymatic activations. So this is the basic part of the envelope, you can consider that is in a eukaryotic envelope of the NEAT concept. When classroom program starts, more than this in the depth by useful diagrams on the board, you can learn directly. Hope you understand. Please attend assignment with the NEAT references. Thank you.